I'm retired now, Tinker.
You can't do that, Cathy. You're a dying breed. You said so yourself.
Well, I'm still a forger. And the older I get, the more worried Mrs. Cuthbertson gets.
There is nothing wrong with good, honest forging. It's a respectable trade. It's done a great deal for mankind.
What do you want?
It's up to you, Cathy. What about a letter? You've done some blinding letters.
Peninsular War.
Perfect.
Anything that you see or hear during the next few nights, Eric, you will remember as purely theoretical. Under our curriculum, this will be categorized as principles of forging.
Practical forging, more like.
Console yourself with the thought that Michelangelo is the most expert forger of the Renaissance era. He only got caught because he bragged about it in the local boozer. Even my idol Fabergé turned his hand to it.
Who, him what made the eggs?
Yes, Catchpole. Him what made the eggs.
Da-da-dee, da-da-da-dee, da-da-dee, da, da-dee, da-dee, da-dee.
Okay, steady.
Morning, Mr. Gimbert. Can I give you a hand?
What?
Oh, right you are.
You're a fit lad. What's happened to your mentor, Lovejoy? What's he up to?
Oh, I'm not sure, actually. I think he's up north on the knocker.
Oh, that desperate, is he?
Back Tuesday, though. Wants to catch Maple Sail. Adamant about that he was.
Oh, yeah?
Apparently.
I used hot pressed paper, dipped in permanganate of potash, and then I frayed it with very fine sandpaper to give it age. I used a real quill pen. And I made some ink by crushing oak galls from the garden. Now, all we've got to do is to give it one or two very hot warmings in the oven.
It's superb, Cathy. It's superb.
Nice to know we can still pull it off, isn't it, Tinker?
Right, I'd like to call this meeting to order. And shouldn't you close the doors?
Oh, the staff are all dismissed for the day. Nobody knows we're here.
I really hope not.
Now, our mark, our target, is Charles Gimbert. His passion is jade. And that bit I put in the auction via Jane is the bait. Charlie will bid for it, but you, Corinna, are going to outbid him. And don't worry if it goes over $3,000. Jane will bankroll you. No, Charlie won't be suspicious. You're a stranger.
What happens when I get the jade?
He'll want a trade-off, but he's got to have something to trade with. Something that will impress an expert like yourself. Something of value. And Tinker's already placed these three items in the auction under a phony name.
But how can you be sure he'll bid for any of these?
Because I'll bid. Charlie's the bane of my life at auctions. He always outbids me on everything. Well, not just to screw me. He knows that if I'm bidding, it's usually for something tasty. That's why I occasionally bid for a bit of crap, so he'll end up with it. But he usually comes out all right. And these are tempting. Gimbert will... Beric! Gimbert will be fooled. There could be one problem. You never know when some local housewife or a pair of newlyweds from Hampstead will pop up with some ludicrous bid. And I don't want any of these forgeries ending up in the hands of some innocent bystander. So, Jane, if Charlie drops out of the bidding, you'll have to outbid anyone else. I can't push it. Look too dodgy.
Right. Got it.
Right early this morning, Lady Jane.
What to do, Stan? Big day.
Well, don't worry. You'll get your money back. We all will.
Mostly rubbish, innit?
You'd know, of course.
No, I'm just going by their reactions.
Oh, they usually rubbish everything. Hide the fact there's something in there that they want. It's called shading the stock.
Your crony Lovejoy back then, eh?
Oh, yeah, wouldn't miss this one.
Why don't you keep your money?
Morning, Fred.
Morning, Lovejoy.
Morning, all.
What's it like, Charlie?
Rubbish, what else?
Oh, maybe, but you know me. No matter what, where the auction, I still get the same old buzz. Somewhere, amongst all the bric-a-brac and tacky trinkets, there's a gem going for a song.
Not here, there isn't.
Is that true, Tink? Excuse me, Charlie.